Okay, while our panelists are seating themselves, is this on? Can you guys hear me? Yes? Okay, good. It is my pleasure to be here tonight to moderate this panel. And as I go around the state, up and down, people are always asking, because I'm from San Francisco, what is going on with this Constitutional Convention? And to tell you the truth, you know, I hear bits and pieces, probably like all of you, and so when I was offered the opportunity to moderate this panel and to hear firsthand from the different groups that are proposing different initiatives, I obviously wanted to do it, so I'm looking forward to learning about the different proposals that are out there, the different groups, and I thank you for caring about California and making reforms, and being in the State Assembly has been very, very frustrating. It is difficult to govern these days. Given our tough fiscal times, our two-thirds requirement to pass a budget and taxes, it's not easy, and so I appreciate any group that wants to help us make reforms at the state level. So today, I am here, Fiona Ma. I'm representing Assembly District 12, which includes the west side of San Francisco, Daly City, Broadmoor, and Colma. California was admitted to the Union as the 31st state after ratifying its first constitution in 1850. But we quickly outgrew our first attempt as the state flourished, and a constitutional convention was convened in 1878 to address calls for reform. The ensuing constitution was ratified in 1879 and is still the law of the land, making it one of the oldest state constitutions in use today. Its long life, coupled with numerous partial reform efforts, have resulted in what is now the world's third longest constitution. With 512 amendments, the Constitution of California is 8 times the length of the U.S. Constitution. One of the many contentious issues in our Constitution is the requirement that we pass a state budget with a two-thirds majority. As a majority whip, one of my main responsibilities is ensuring that bills that make it to the floor of the Assembly have the needed votes to pass. Accordingly, I'm keenly aware of the difficulties that are presented by requiring a supermajority vote on difficult issues such as taxes and budgets. In fact, the California legislature has been unable to pass a budget by the end of the fiscal year in 22 of the last 30 years, a problem which ends up costing the state millions. But the problems in California run much deeper than difficulties faced with a budget. In a state that touts an economy larger than all but 10 countries, it is unacceptable that our per pupil spending in public schools has dropped to 47th in the nation, that we have two of the most congested regions in the country, and that our unemployment rate is higher than the national average. What's worse, California is consistently ranked the worst state in which to do business. In light of these very serious problems, a movement has been growing which would rewrite the California Constitution. There is some disagreement, however, as to what the best way is to achieve the reforms that are necessary to get California back on track. Some, such as Matt Regan from the Bay Area Council and Repair California, or Robert Cruikshank from the Courage Campaign, are calling for a California Constitutional Convention where delegates will convene to determine these reforms. Others, such as Dennis Quillen with California Forward, proposes making these reforms through the initiative process. And also joining us today is Blair Bobier with the New America Foundation, which has acted in an advisory role but does not have an initiative on their own which they are advancing. These respective organizations were invited to participate today by the San Francisco Young Democrats because of their varying approaches and insights in this very important issue. I'm happy to participate because I believe in the importance of engaging the public early in this process and to assure everyone is educated about the various vehicles so that we can all be part of determining the best road to reform. So thank you all very much for being here.